Hello, this is Jeff from Baron Leathercraft, and today we are going to do a review on the Algolaser. This is particularly the DIY Kit Mini. It's their affordable and upgradable laser. Algolaser has other lasers that are pretty much all put together. They're more expensive. I have the Algo Delta, actually the 22 watt laser, which I did a review on, and I thought it was excellent. So we're going to take a look at the DIY kit today. You have to build it on your own on the most part, but at the same rate, you also learn about your laser when you build them. So if anything does go wrong, you understand a little bit more about the tensioning of the belts and all the major functionings of the machine because you're going to be building it. So I'm going to focus basically on letting you know how simple it was to put together and the quality of the engraving and all the major features of whatever this thing can do. So let's go ahead and dive into that. All right, we're going to start with an unboxing just so we know what is coming with this laser. If you haven't bought a laser before, I'll explain a bunch of this stuff. When you use the laser, there could be a little soot left over onto your whatever you're engraving, and this is to brush it off. We have a certificate of conformity, which basically is letting us know that they put it together properly. We're going to have to run cables when we put this together. Zip tie, there's the word I'm looking for. And these are some samples to be able to engrave on. They're like business cards. They're most likely aluminum. Here's the manual. Here's another piece of wood they give you to test. Feels like basswood. You have a USB-C cable. This is your power cable. This is your hose for your air assist, which is always an important aspect of laser engraving. Here's your goggles. This is something we will find out what it is. No idea yet. This looks like an extra lens, or at least an extra lens cover. Let's go over here. These look like a pair of legs. This will help support it. There's probably two more of these. Yeah, I feel them in there. These are, you know, part of the frame. These are probably the left and right side or the front and back. Dive deeper. Here's some more of the frame. Over here we have brackets to put the machine together. These are most likely the corners. And here is the laser module. This is a 10 watt module. It's ready for air assist. Over here we have different screws and cabling. It's all hooked together. All the screws are in the same bag, which is probably fine. The power supply is connected to it, I see. The limit switches are connected to it. These are called limit switches. This alerts the machine of how big of a space you actually have to work with. It basically clicks on this switch and it knows to stop. Otherwise, the motors would just go on. So this is basically telling the machine, hey, stop, this is the end of the machine. So this is your gantry. It's put together a little more than I expected. This is your power, and this is your basically the whole, your motherboard, all the brains that will connect to the machine. That pretty much is everything that's in there minus the other two pair of feet that I didn't get to show you. So I'm going to go ahead and put this together, and I'll give you a synopsis of how easy it was. And I will be right back with the magic power of editing. Now I'll share with you how easy it is to put this machine together. Here is the first step, connecting the frame, and then slide on the gantry once you have the frame connected. Go ahead and screw the corner pieces in to make sure that the machine is stable. Then you have these outside corner pieces. At this point, you want to go ahead and put in the belt. The gantry already has the belt put in it. Now I'm screwing in one of the stop sensors and sliding the laser module into its bracket, going ahead and tightening the bracket so the module sticks still. Here I'm screwing the brain into the machine. This is where your control panel is. At this point, you want to take the cable that's running from the brain of the machine and plug it into all the areas that are necessary, like the laser module right here. Everything's marked. Now the system is running fine and I have it connected with Wi-Fi. If you happen to have more than one laser machine and they're both Wi-Fi, it's easy to switch back and forth between each machine. Focusing is easy. You just take what I'll call the focus spacer and you place it underneath the laser between your material, and then you go ahead and lower the laser and you want it to be touching on the lip of the laser spacer. And then go ahead and tighten the laser once again, the laser module that is. And that's how simple it is to go ahead and focus this laser module. Framing material with this laser is easy. As you can see the laser dot as it travels around this black coaster. So even on black material, it's easy to go ahead and frame with this laser. I engraved this slate coaster at 5,000 millimeters a minute and 70% power. This is what I most commonly use when I use a 10 watt laser. I was happy with the way it came out. I thought the detail was excellent. If you want to check out my other reviews, I normally use this design, so you could go ahead and make some comparisons, but I was happy with the outcome. I was very happy with the way this machine cut and engraved wood. I thought that the darkness was very consistent. This one I did at 6,000 millimeters at 70% power. And I also did one even slower to get a darker look. This one's done at 4,000 millimeters a minute and 70% power. And I cut at 300 millimeters a minute and at 90% power. And it cut really well. I personally like that smoke residue look that you see, that kind of yellowing, but that'll come out really easy if you take some sandpaper and you can sand it for a few seconds and that'll be out of there. The fact that this machine engraves well and cuts well and is Wi-Fi, I'll be using this machine quite often. Once again, if you are a leather crafter and you don't have a laser, go get a laser. Leather really engraves well. Now, you notice the smoky area on this leather? It's really easy to take off. So after I engrave anything with on leather, I'll go ahead and wipe it off. And look how much cleaner it is. See, all that residue is gone. That's also why you want air assist. Air assist will help keep that from gathering, but washing off your leather after you engrave, it really came out excellent. One thing I wanted to point out about this machine is notice the center area where the stars are and everything surrounding the stars, the dark area. Look how consistent that is. You got to remember that this laser keeps moving back and forth horizontally, creating very thin lines. You see how nice it is, how detailed it is? There's really no space. It looks like just one solid stroke. That is really a good sign for a quality laser module. This is a patch that I use for one of my leather crafts. If you notice, all the holes cut out very well. This is pre-wash. Now, take a look at it after I wash it. Leather just really works great with lasers. It really came out nice. I wanted to do a little bit more detailed pattern, like the Celtic knot there, and everything really came out very nice. If you plan on using your laser for leathercraft, I recommend getting a laser where the cap on the bottom of the module comes off like that. Thinner leather can sometimes curl, snagging onto the bottom of the module. If you're able to take it off, it'll prevent this. Algolaser also sent me a honeycomb bed. This one measures at 400 millimeters by 400 millimeters. It seems to be steel because my magnets do work on it. The frame is aluminum, and behind it there is an actual piece of aluminum that protects the table or whatever countertop you happen to have the machine on. I also noticed it was too big for the DIY Kit Mini. The gantry wheels would rub up against it. I took a deeper look and I found on Amazon that Algolaser is selling their honeycomb bed at the size of 320 millimeters by 320 millimeters. This one was made particularly for the DIY Kit Mini. For some reason, I didn't find this particular item on their website when I checked. It might exist there now, but at the time I looked, it didn't. But this is a honeycomb bed that will fit your laser engraver. In any case, this will fit perfectly with my Aglo Delta laser 22 watt. It's larger than the one I have now, which means I'll have more space to engrave and cut with. So, after spending some time with the Algo DIY Kit Mini 10 watt laser, I have to say I'm genuinely impressed. This little machine really nails it when it comes to engraving and cutting. If you're on a budget, this is a great option. It gives you solid performance without breaking the bank. Honestly, it doesn't matter if you're dropping $1,000 or $300 on a laser engraver. What really counts is whether it does what you need it to do. And this one definitely does everything I need on a quality level. For this reason, I feel it would be a good choice for hobbyists and professionals alike, depending on your needs. Plus, I love that it connects via Wi-Fi to both Windows and phone apps, making it super convenient to use. All in all, if you're looking for an affordable, reliable laser engraver that gets the job done, the Algolaser DIY Kit Mini should definitely be on your list of choices. Thanks for watching, and if you have any thoughts or questions, drop them in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. It is truly appreciated. And of course, be good to each other. We play a role in shaping our lives and the lives of others. Take care and enjoy.